Objective-C interface method declaration. So I told you in the previous video that inside the interface method interface section, this is where we declare all our methods. We do not write codes for the method, we just declare them. So now let's break those methods down and just look at exactly how we declare methods. So if you look at the bank account program, we have these methods that we have declared in the interface section of the program. We have the set account number, the set account balance, the get account number, the get account balance, all these methods. And I think later on I added the details method. So let us use a simple declaration for now. We'll use the get account number method. So this is one method that we're going to break down, get account number. So what does this negative mean? What does this minus mean? What does this int mean? What does this get account? So when this method is called in our program, when we use Johnson account and get account number, remember this is how we use method on an object. When we send a message to the object, we use it like this. So we use the object and the method. So we are expecting, even if you think about that in your head for a minute, when you say Johnson account, then get account number, we are expecting the account number to be returned to us. So it means this particular method returns some form of data back to us. So this get account number, it will return some information back to us, which is the account number. This type of method is called a getter. So in programming language, we call this method type, we call it a getter, because what it does is it gets something and it sends it back to us. It gets an information and sends it back. In this case, it gets the bank account number of Johnson and return it to be up to the object that calls the method. So when you use this object, when you send this message, this method as a message to the object, it would get the account number that belonged to the Johnson account and return it back into the program. At the back of the method name, we have the minus int, and the minus, we'll talk more about that in the next video. But the integer simply means that the type of information that we're expecting from the method call is an integer. So this int means that the information that this method will return is an integer. So it makes sense, isn't it? Because if you look at let's go to the program. Because if you look at the top, the account number has been declared as an integer here. Account number is an integer. So what do we expect? We expect an integer to be returned back to us when we call this get account number. So this is why this int means here. It means that when we call this program, we expect an integer to return back to us. Think about this for a minute. If you give this classifier to another programmer, he knows what data type to expect back from get account number, and he or she can work with the method safely in his program. So this method, all it does is return the value of the account number of type integer. So this method returns the value of the account number of type integer. Similarly, another getter method, this is another getter method. This is one is used to get the account balance. This one returns the account balance as a float to the object that calls the method. So this method does nothing other than return. So let's look in our program at how we actually code out, even though we're still going to talk more about it in the implementation videos. So if you look at the account number here, the only statement we have inside it is say return account number. And if we look at get account balance, the only statement we have inside when we actually write the code, is to return the account balance. So this is what this minus and int at the back of it mean. We're going to look at what this void and stuff, the rest of it means in the next video. Thank you.